bought a new car. Welcome back to the channel. As you can tell by the title and by this clip, I got a new car. I finally got an E30. All right, so this is my brand new, well, this is my new to me 1987 BMW 325 IS. Before I show you guys any more details of the car, I need to run it back a few days or like a few weeks to when I got the car, because when I bought this car, it wasn't running. It had a blown motor and we had to do a lot of work to get it running, but now we're here. I don't know how I'm gonna do this editing, but let me try and rewind all the way back to when I picked it up and show you guys everything that was wrong with this car. I thought it was gonna be an easy fix. It was an easy fix, but dude, this car needed so much work. So let me rewind to that, and then you guys will see me at the end of the video again in this exact spot. But let me go back and show you guys everything that was wrong with the car and what it took to get it here. All right, as you guys saw, we got an E30 on the channel. Finally, bro, I've been looking for an E30 for years, bro. It's literally like 3-4 years I've been looking for an E30. It's not like crazy, but I've always wanted one. Here with the homie David. And like I said before, the car wasn't running when I first got it. Hopefully, at the beginning of this video, the car's running and I show it to you guys running. Cause then that means we got it figured out. But as of now, I've had the car for like 2 weeks. I bought it, it wasn't running. Supposedly it needs a new motor. I don't think it does. And we're gonna tear into it today. Finally, I haven't touched it. I literally brought it home. It's been in David's garage ever since. So today, me and Dave are gonna just tear into it. I'm gonna take off the valve cover. I think it's a noise in the head. In the next hour, we're gonna find out what kind of direction we need to go and kind of what the car needs to get running. Hopefully, it's something small. Hopefully, I popped the valve cover and like one of the rocker arms broke and it just needs a rocker arm. Who knows? Or the motor jump timing or something. We'll figure that out in a bit. So we're gonna head over to the shop and start tearing into the E30. Alright, little short story before we actually tear into it. When I bought this car, I saw it on Marketplace. I went to go look at it as soon as possible. He ended up knowing one of my homies, and my homie has an E30. He knows everything about E30s basically. And I hit him up and basically I went to go pick up the car. It was for a really good price, comparable to what E30s are, at least for what E30s are on the market right now. And like I said, I've been looking for an E30 forever. Everything was perfect on the car, but the last owner thought that the motor on this car was actually blown up. I already expected it to be blown up, obviously. So in my head, I already thought about rebuilding the motor, which I was willing to do for the price already. But after hearing the car in person, I don't think that the motor's blown. I'm gonna put a clip on the screen right now of what it sounds like. In person, when I went to go look at it, it sounded like it was coming from the head. When I brought it back to the shop, I turned it on for David, and he thought the exact same thing as me, that it's coming from the head. So I'm pretty sure it's a problem in the head, because it doesn't sound like typical rod knock. So I think something in the head's messed up. I don't know if it's gonna need a new head, but hopefully not. And hopefully just like one of the rockers came off, or like the valves need to be adjusted. It sounds like one of the valves is coming in contact with the piston. That's what it sounds like to me. Another thing it could be is it could have probably jumped timing. It could have jumped the tooth or something timing, and then the pistons are hitting the valves. Those are the two things I'm hoping for. If it's not those two, then it's probably gonna be something worse. But those are the two things I'm hoping for, because those are probably gonna be the easiest fix. So for right now, I'm gonna call up my homie right now and try and get a game plan. I think what I want to do is we're gonna take off this valve cover
I don't think we have to take off the intake manifold. I don't think so. It should be easy. It's just all these bolts around here.
I've never worked on an older BMW. I've only worked on like 2005 and up, I think, like an E46 and up. Or actually, I had an E36. That was like a 99, I believe. I don't know anything about these motors. I don't know how to take them apart. I don't know what the problems are with these. So I'm gonna call up my homie. He knows a lot more about E30s and M20s more than me. So I'm gonna call him up and we're gonna get a game plan. But I think where I'm gonna start is we're gonna take a look inside the head and see if I notice anything out of the ordinary. If not, then we might have to remove the head and check everything, so. Back to the drawing board.
Well, you never know, somebody's gonna have play. But inside of here, everything looks pretty okay.
Oh, bro, look.
Oh! Nah, you smart as hell.
I didn't see it.
Bro, it's literally a broken rocker arm. The rocker literally snapped right there. Where's the magnet? Oh, that shit's stuck in there. Damn. Yeah, that's not gonna get out. That's literally perfect, bro. That's why the car's down on power. It's literally down a whole exhaust.
Bro, how you not see that, bro?
You didn't see it at first either.
Well, I was looking at it from this side. You can't see it.
Yeah, I literally scanned it. All right, good, 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 good. Damn. Give me a flathead.
These sides look good.
Hold on. Is it? Oh, wait. Oh, it's not even jammed in there. Damn.
Nah, it's gonna get all right.
I worked tonight, so I was like, I'm just gonna take the head off. We're probably gonna see like a catastrophic failure on the inside.
The homie
yeah, bro. Logan, if you're watching this, dog, I'm sorry, bro. It was just a rocker arm. Hopefully, you never know. Yeah, you never know, because a rocker arm could do a lot of damage, but that's what the noise was, bro.
Yeah, that's literally what the noise was, because it had no resistance against the spring.
It's still going to be a little bit of work, for sure, because I think the head has to be removed. Yeah, because this rod inside of here is not going to slide out. I think this entire rod has to slide out.
Yeah,
unless there's a way to remove this, but I don't think there is.
Nah.
It literally couldn't have broken a better spot, because usually it breaks and it could cut, like, literally if it got stuck under here, it could have just tore up the cam.
Destroyed the cam.
Yeah, it would have destroyed the cam. The cam looks good. Like, there's no scoring in the walls. Like, it doesn't look like it was dancing anywhere. It looks like it literally broke off and just fell and got stuck in that corner and it never came back up. So that's good. That explains why the car was down on power and why it sounded crazy. Yeah, it was literally a clean snap. You think we could super glue that back in place?
Probably. We rolled it.
Throw a little tack on top.
Damn, bro. Logan, if you're watching this, I was right. It was probably. I told him, I was like, it might just be a broken rocker arm. And then I saw him, he was like, yeah, it could be, maybe. But it did sound crazy. So I can see why you thought it was a blown motor. Because even my head, I was like 50-50. It's either something in the head or something in the bottom end is fucked up. Because I don't know what rod knock on these sound like. Rod knock sounds. Nah, it sounds the same on like every motor.
Yeah, but rod knock sounds strong. You can
Yeah, it wasn't that bad. But it could have been a slight like rod knock, like a very slight, like a bearing, like a bearing being worn, and it wasn't that bad yet. He said he heard the noise and it was down on power and he turned it off and he parked it since he never broke into it. I wonder if this broke because they didn't adjust the valves right. Because like a month or two before this happened, the valves were adjusted on the car at the shop. They're old, bro. It's almost a 40-year-old engine. The head's still gonna have to come off. But hopefully the head's still reusable. And hopefully this didn't damage anything else inside of the head. That's crazy though, how one little like rocker arm being broken could just cause like, I wish this was like an SR20. I think SR20s are, the rockers could be like removed individually. You don't have to pull that giant rod out of there. So let me call up Connor and see if there's a way to do this without removing the head, but I don't think there is.
There's a way to do this. After some research, I found out that we can replace the rockers without having to remove the head, but you have to take off the entire cooling system and the grill so that this rod could just slide out all the way to the front of the car. So it's either that or just pull the head and then replace everything, but then I'm also gonna have to replace the head gasket.
Because if I'm just replacing one rocker, I might as well just take out the cooling system and just slide the rod out and replace that one rocker. But I think I'm gonna just replace all the rockers, because if one already broke, then I don't want to have to risk the rest of them breaking. So I don't know if the car's gonna be running in this video. All right, I'm gonna do some research, see what we do, see what parts I'm gonna need and what tools I'm gonna need. And I'm gonna order everything, but at least now I know for sure what it is. And pretty 99% positive it was just that broken rocker. And hopefully after this, the car's drivable and I'll have a fucking fully working E30. So next clip you guys see, we're gonna be tearing into it and getting this car back on the road. Hopefully at the beginning of this video, the car's already driving, because that means we already fixed it. If not, then we're starting the video now. I just finished my truck too. I just put on the wheels on it from last video. So I gotta detail that,
show you guys that whole process. So I'll see you guys in a bit.
We back, got the E30 here. I forgot what the last clip already was. I think I just showed you guys the car. We took off the valve cover, I showed you guys a broken rocker. Today, we're gonna be fixing the rocker. I got two options.
Option number one, which is probably what I should be doing, and I ordered parts. I ordered a head gasket and everything just in case I do need to do it. But option number one is we need to remove the actual head. But we don't wanna do that because if you remove the head, you have to take off the intake manifold, the exhaust manifold. It just turns into like a 4-hour job
or even longer. But instead, me and David are gonna try and remove the rockers, the rocker like shafts, with the head still attached to the car. I've only seen one video and one guy do it, but me and David kind of had the same idea. So hopefully we don't have to remove the head, but I'm prepared to remove the head. I bought the parts for it, but I'm really hoping I don't have to do that.
So if we're not gonna remove the head, we need to remove the radiator, the front grille, the hood, obviously, to make it easier. David's working on removing the hood right now. But we need to basically remove everything in the front
so that these rocker shafts can slide all the way out through the grille, through the front of the car.
They should come out like that. I was just worried about breaking all the stuff in here, but I really don't wanna remove the head right now. I wanna enjoy this car already. And yeah, David's already taken off the hood, but before we take any of this off, I bought a tool that we're gonna use right now. I went and bought a bore scope. It's just like a long, how do you explain this shit, David? The booty hole finder. I think it's not a borescope, it's like an endoscope or something. Basically, this long wire has a camera at the end of it. But basically, we're gonna be using this to look inside of the motor because
this is the rocker that's broken. I think that's cylinder 2, I believe, because I believe that, yeah, there's 2 valves per cylinder. So that means I need to take off the cylinder 2 spark plug and see this piston right here. Because even though this rocker is broken and we're gonna replace the rocker, I don't wanna remove the head. But the con about not removing the head is there could be a bent valve and we won't be able to tell unless we pull the head, obviously, or at least the exhaust manifold and stick something in there. But hopefully with this tool, I could just take off the spark plug and put the tool into the spark plug and try and see the valve. If there's no contact damage on the valve, then there's no way it could be bent. And we're gonna go ahead and just speed run the rest of this and get this car running. But on my 240, the spark plug's on the top. There will be no way to look at the valves on top because there will be up here past the camera. There's a special like endoscope you could buy. I'll put it on the screen right now. It's like an oscillating one. I tried to find one of those, but I couldn't. I literally just thought about this today and I bought that right now. But the way that the spark plug is on the side right here, I think if we stick the borescope in there, we might be able to see the top where the valves are. So I'm gonna get started on that, and David's gonna be removing the hood, and we're gonna wait on this until we see if the valve's bent. Because if the valve is bent, then we have to pull the head. Like if it's like a tiny amount of bent, honestly, bro, I might just drive it. It might misfire a little bit. Yo, I just wanna drive this car. But nah, if the valve has any damage on it, I'll just pull the head because I'm gonna obviously have to fix the valve train. Hopefully the head's not damaged, but I really don't think that the valve is gonna be bent because the car turns on fine. It sounds crazy, obviously, because there's no, it's down a valve on one of the cylinders. Let me put the camera inside there and hopefully we see no damage on the valve.
David forgot to press record,
but we got the camera in here. I put this video on the screen right now, but I can't get a good look at the piston. There's a little indentation in the piston right there. I don't know if these pistons are supposed to be flat or if that made contact with the valve. So we're gonna take off cylinder 1 spark plug and we're gonna look inside this piston. If this piston has that same groove, then we'll be fine. But we're gonna check all of them basically just to see the condition of the pistons.
We have to remove these spark plugs out of the way because we're gonna be manually turning the motor when we remove the rockers. And taking out the spark plugs is gonna make it turn a lot easier. So we're gonna take a look inside all of these.
Hopefully every single piston has this and the piston just has an indentation for the actual valve.
We got cylinder 1 spark plug out and we were tripping because they were different sizes.
Logan, if you're watching this, the past owner of this car, did you fucking change the spark plug on cylinder number 2 thinking that the rattling was a misfire, bro? Unless we take out the rest of them and some of them are like mismatched. Cylinder 2, he took out the spark plug and it kept misfiring. I think he changed the spark plug on only that one cylinder. He didn't change the rest of the spark plug.
This was the first one, obviously the one that we're trying to look at the valves, and it looks new. I thought it was new, but it is. That's because it is new, I'm pretty sure. This is a 21 millimeter. This is the biggest spark plug I've ever seen. This was like a 5/8. I don't know what that is, like a fucking 14 or something. But yeah, this is crazy, but this is the OEM spec. So luckily I did have a deep 21, or I had a 13/16, some shit like that. Yeah, so this is a 13/16 socket. It's a deep 21, but a 13/16 worked. But we're gonna take off the rest of them. Hopefully all the rest of them are this and the last one are just used one of these, but you should never do that. So now I gotta change the spark plugs on the car. We're gonna take them all off, take a look in the cylinders. Hopefully every cylinder has that little indentation I was telling you guys about. Literally, as soon as I turn off the camera, David already had it on cylinder 1.
Yeah. I'll put it on the screen right now. But we're gonna take off the rest of the spark plugs, and I think we're gonna start taking off everything on the front. And hopefully, in the next few hours, this car's running, bro. Like,
we got this little mirror attachment onto the actual bore scope, and basically, we're gonna try and see it at 90. So this way, we're gonna try and look on the top. We're gonna go in through the spark plug, and we're gonna try and point towards the valves and see if there's any contact on the valves. But I'm pretty sure there's not, because we don't see anything crazy. But just a good thing to check, because if we do see contact on any of the valves, the head has to come off.
Good news, probably not gonna use the camera to look inside of pistons anymore, because the little like mirror attachment is not the most secure thing ever. And I was like, bro, like this shit barely fits through the spark plug hole. Imagine that little mirror piece gets stuck in the piston, and then you have to remove the head to fucking get that mirror piece out. I showed you guys the valve. We were able to look at the one valve that the rocker's on, and it doesn't have any damage to it. So we're gonna go ahead and do the plan that we were gonna do and try not to remove the head. Let's get started on taking out the front end of the car part. I take the radiator off, the grills, and the headlights off, I think. Hopefully this car is running soon.
I'm pretty sure we only have to take off this front side of the car. David was taking that off, but I don't see why we'll have to remove that, because the shafts are gonna pull out straight through here. So you have to take out the kidney grill. It's just two clips at the top right here.
They look like these over here.
Two clips, and that was it. No, actual grill is just one clip, two clips, one screw right here, and another screw right here, and that was basically it. So now we're gonna take off the radiator and then literally start taking off stuff right here and then pull the shafts out. Hopefully everything goes as planned. Pretty smooth so far. This is what I was scared about. I'm not worried about that. I could pull this whole motor apart. The problem is, if you break one of these plastics, bro, like, they're gonna be so hard to find. I already broke this clip up here on the grill over there, but you don't really see it. So as long as nothing in the front, and as long as it's still sturdy, I'm chilling. Still sucks though. Let's start getting the radiator off and get all that shit out. We got the radiator out. Next thing we're gonna do is take off this distributor cap. I think it's just those three bolts, and this cap will come off. Hopefully I don't have to remove all these wires. I took a picture just in case that we have to put this back, because I don't want to mess with timing or anything. So, but I know this cap has to come off. Hopefully this comes off out as one piece, and we can just leave this aside. We might have to take the front timing cover, which I think is under here. So we'll see. I'll check back in with an update, but right now we're gonna try and take this off. The distributor out, it was just those three bolts I told you, and inside of here that shield came out. But these three bolts right here is for the button, I think you call it. I don't know what it's called. The cap, this is the rotor, I guess. Yeah, this is the rotor.
I think this shield will come out too in here. This cover has to come off right here, I believe, and then we'll get access to the gears with the holes to take the shafts out. So let me take this cover off, and then after that cover's off, we could start working on the valve train. We gotta do some research, but basically this has to come off because I really don't want to take out this timing gear and redo timing or risk losing it. So, cause then all this shit, the bottom has to come off. If we could just figure out how to get this plastic off, we'll be good.
Oh, I got it. Nope, I would've won. So we had to take out this bolt. I used a big ass breaker board and I got scared cause I kind of felt to like almost strip it. But I just put my impact on it and I gave it a couple zaps and it came right out. I put it back in already. I put it hand tight for now because we're gonna have to manually turn the actual engine. I'm debating if I should even put this plastic cover on right here. It was this one, and we had to remove it basically to be able to see these gaps inside of the timing gear. We gotta take out those plugs right there, those black plugs right here, right next to my finger. Those come out easy, but then the shaft should just come out right through there. So we'll line up the holes on the gear and then the shaft should be able to come out. So let's do that. All right, we took out the two covers right here and the ones in the back. You gotta take out the ones in the back because you kind of need leverage. You'll see you guys in a bit. We kind of have to push the rod off in that way. Basically, I think all that's left for these for this shaft to slide out is we gotta take off all these clips right here. There you go. They just literally pop out, and then the rockers become loose. That one came out easy because it was the one on top of the broken rocker. The rockers have the, these eccentrics right here in the inside, and it's a really skinny Allen. We had to loosen those all the way basically, and that will let us let the rocker have play, I believe. So. And then we have to take all this apart to be able to slide the shafts out, take the rockers off one by one, and then reassemble it. So hopefully we could get all that done in the next hour.
All right, man. As always, some shit came up. two bad things. One, we can't get that stupid ass rod out of there. It just won't budge. We could probably get it out, but like, I don't even want to deal with that shit. So me and David decided that we're just gonna just pull ahead, bro. I'm annoyed because we could have already had the head off right now if we knew we were gonna do that from the beginning. I already had the head gasket and stuff at home just in case we did have to pull the head, and we should have just started to pull the head from the beginning. So I put some PB blaster on the exhaust studs. Hopefully the studs don't break tomorrow. But basically throughout this week, we're gonna try and get them done. I have to get this car out by Saturday because I'm taking it to my girlfriend's house for a big party and I want to show it to everyone. So yeah, we're kind of on a time crunch, but basically we're just gonna be putting the head and I'll show you guys the car after. I'm not gonna be detailed on how we pull the head. Pretty straightforward, same thing as the 240. So the only thing holding in the head is
the intake manifold bolts on that side, the exhaust manifolds on this side, there's two of them. And then the only thing on the front holding it, I think, is this belt right here. So we're gonna try and take this belt off, and then we're probably gonna have to do the timing. I'm gonna try not to remove all the shit in the front of the motor, but we might have to. So I don't know, basically we're gonna just remove the head. With the head removed, we'll be able to actually take it apart and rebuild it. So
even with the head removed, I don't know how the fuck those dowels are gonna come off. All this for a stupid ass rocker. Why the fuck did BMW make a rocker shaft? Like, they couldn't have made each fucking rocker like work individually, bro. This shit would have been so easy of a fix. But whatever, we're gonna clean up and I'll see you guys in a bit.
The very next day, me and David went straight to work on the E30 and did everything we had to do to remove the head, which was take off the intake manifold, the exhaust manifolds, and the front timing gear. And there was also a coolant line at the back of the head. After all that was out, the head was just able to slip right out. Also, if you guys made it this far in this video, drop a like. It really helps me out a lot. And also, let me know in the comments if you guys like the longer videos or the shorter videos. I read every single comment. I reply to every single comment. So your feedback is really appreciated. Let me know.
Day two, like I told you guys in the voiceover. Me and David just went crazy ham today. We're just trying to take everything off because we lost the whole day yesterday too, basically. And we only have two more days after today to get this running because we can't work on it Friday and I need it by Saturday. But let me give you guys a little update. Bro, this shit is crazy. Hey, but if it works, it's not stupid.
All right, so first of all, I got both manifolds off. I didn't take out the three triangle bolts at the bottom. I just took these off right here and pried it off. So now they're loose, so the head should be able to just come out. We got the intake manifold off. That shit was a bitch to take off. That shit is way harder than the 240. I'm dreading putting that back on, but yeah, that was a nightmare to take off. There's also a coolant line at the back of the head right here. We removed that. So literally the only thing holding this on was the front timing belt.
This is our solution to not have to time it later, because me and David really don't want to remove all this because we're on a time crunch and we don't want to lose timing. So the motor's already at top dead center before we even did anything. So we knew it was already at TDC. And basically like what we did with the 240, as long as the timing isn't lost down there, we can adjust up here and slip the gear on. So we marked the timing belt right there with the paint marker in two areas, and we just slipped the cam out and just held it in place. And then David got some fucking weed whacker wire.
Bro, that's crazy, bro. We tied it to the fucking frame of the garage, and that's the only thing keeping this car in time right now.
If this falls or breaks or whatever, we're gonna lose timing at the bottom and then all that has to come off, which isn't the worst case in the world, but we really don't want to lose it.
The only thing holding the head in are these head bolts right here. So once those head bolts are out, the head should literally just pop off. We could clean everything up. I could put the new head gasket, and honestly, I could put the head back on today, hopefully.
I have work tonight. I didn't sleep for shit in the past like 2 days. I'm tired, but the only thing keeping me going is how excited I am to drive this car. We're gonna take off the head bolts right now, take off the head. Hopefully today too, we could put at least the head back on, and then tomorrow we could come back and put the intake manifold and the exhaust. But who knows, let's see how much we can get done. But for sure, I at least want to take the head off and clean so that tomorrow we just got to put everything back together. Let's time lapse this and see how far we get today.
Is that the way, no?
One. Okay.
Thank you.
that's it for today. Homie David gotta leave right now. We got the head off, as you guys saw.
Head's right here. Bro, a part of me wants to just take this to the machine shop and get it hot tanked and just pressure tested and everything. Just basically refresh because it's super dirty.
But David convinced me to just enjoy the car. And honestly, I really just want to enjoy the car because my problem is I'll tear something apart. I'm like, oh, I could do this, this, this. And yeah, you could do it, but it's not necessary. This car ran pretty good before. And even now, it turned on and everything. You just had the rocker tick because the rocker was down. So I think I'm gonna just put everything back together, like I said. Let me show you guys how the block looks.
Tomorrow we're gonna come back and we're gonna clean the surfaces. Hopefully with the head out, we can actually take the rocker shafts out, which we should be able to. We're probably gonna have to hammer them out. So we're gonna do that, replace the rockers. We're gonna take out the head gasket, swap the head gasket, clean everything up, and yeah, just basically install the head.
But let me peel the head gasket and see what the fuck it looks like. Okay, never mind.
I'll do that tomorrow.
Everything looks nice and even. It doesn't look like the head gasket was leaking at all. Hopefully the underside of the head gasket looks fine too.
Hopefully everything tomorrow should at least be hooked up and basically like 80, 90% finished.
And then there's also a small chance that we could even get the car running tomorrow. Basically, we just gotta put everything back together. I don't know if I told you guys, but David lost a nut the other day and he dropped it somewhere. We have no idea where it went, but it's not in the piston, so that's a good sign. It could be in the oil pan. There's an oil pickup tube with the filter for a reason. We might drop the oil pan, I'm not sure, because I really don't want to go through all this work and we turn it on and that little nut just destroys the motor, which is really rare, but it's always possible. So, but yeah, I'll come back tomorrow. I'm off, no sleep. I'm not going to sleep today again either, but hopefully tomorrow it's all worth it when the car's running. We'll get started working on the car soon again. Day 3, here with Homie David. One of us is going to tackle the head, the other one's going to tackle the block.
David's gonna go ahead, take off the head gasket, clean this up. It doesn't look too dirty like my 240, so it should be fine. And then I got some oil right here. There's like 3 different oils that could come in this transmission from factory. So I got 2 of them. They didn't have the third one, but I don't think it's gonna be the third one. I got this cheap oil and some of this just in case, cause I don't know if I showed you guys, but there's like a fucking, that's coolant, but there's like some oil from the trans that's leaking out right there. This car's gonna get fully refreshed later, so I'm not worried about it. I just wanna be able to drive it. And if it's leaking out for 2 weeks of sitting here, who knows how long the transmission's been leaky for? Who knows when the last time it was filled up? The last thing I wanna do is get the motor running and drive it with no trans fluid and mess up my transmission. This is a good transmission too. This is a Get Rag 260 5-speed. This is the one that everyone wants, so I don't wanna mess it up. So I got some oil for that. He's gonna get the car ready to get the head.
I'm gonna get the head ready. So I'm gonna basically hammer this out with the big ass hammer. Hopefully it's not too hard. I'm gonna have to hit it with like a dowel or some shit. But I'm gonna get these rocker shafts out, get these rockers out, slip the new shafts in with the new rockers, and hopefully it goes smooth. So I'll work on this. After I'm done with that, I'm gonna clean the surfaces on both sides and this will be ready.
Hopefully at the bare minimum, everything's put back together today, but who knows, I could probably get the car running today. We have one more day, we have tomorrow, and that's basically the last day because me and David both can't work on it Friday.
Everything looks good. All the coolant passages aren't like rusted out and stuff. It looks like it was well taken care of.
Let me get this head ready. Rocker shaft out, and I think what we messed up on, as you guys saw in the time lapse, I had to like basically sand down the end of it. I think when we were trying to pry on it, we were like bending the tip and stuff, and the tolerance is so small that any little nick and stuff was just keeping this from coming out.
So. Oh, you know what? We were probably smacking the fuck out of it, and it flared.
Yeah, it did flare.
Yeah.
And then like the bean saws grabbing on it and stuff, like it probably just messed up the end of it. So I kind of just sanded it down a bit. It's like not too noticeable. But I sanded it down. Right now, we're gonna clean the entire. Well, I'm gonna take out the other rocker shaft. We gotta try and find a way to spin the cam. Before we put them in, we're gonna clean them, put some assembly lube on them, and hopefully they just slide right in. And with the new rockers and the shafts in there, it should be ready to just put back on the car and just put everything back together. So hopefully we get the car running today, or at least back together today.
We got both shafts out. I'm gonna clean them up. I'm gonna clean the gaskets, basically get the head ready. So I'll do that in a bit. But we made an interesting discovery.
So right here we got,
bro, I don't know why the fuck the last owner put that on there. That's just funny though, that's just thing. We found something interesting.
So the pistons have a little bit of play. I mean, it's an old ass motor, so the rings are for sure worn out. That's why you run a thick ass oil. I'm gonna run a 10W40 in it. I think the stock's like 5W40 or something. But yeah, hopefully that's not a problem. But I ain't doing shit about it right now. I'm gonna do 100W100. I'm gonna run Aunt Jemima. All the cylinders have a little bit of play. There's no play up and down. I don't think so.
Yeah.
There's no play up and down, so that's fine. That means that the bearings are fine. But yeah, there's a little bit of play in the pistons. If the motor ever blows on this shit, like a year or something, or a few months from now, I'm gonna come back to this video. But it should be fine. I think it'll run fine, especially with a really thick oil in there. Let's get everything back together. I just wanted to show you guys, because that was kind of funny. Let's get everything back together. Hopefully the car's back together in a few hours. Little update, me and David are done basically. We got the head put back together. I didn't record it because we're rushing. The head is ready. We cleaned all the surfaces. You've cleaned everything in the engine bay, right? Yeah, so everything's ready to put the head back on, but I gotta go back home and sleep because I work tonight. But yeah, the head's together. And I think I have good news. If anyone in the comments knows about E30s or M20s or BMWs in general, I need some input because I think I have an 885 head, which I know is a good head. But there's something about like AMC, it doesn't have a BMW logo, but mine has the 885 casting and the 2.5 casting on the exhaust side, but it also has a BMW logo, so I need some help. So someone comment down below and let me know what head I have, because I think it's an 885, which would be sick because I heard that's the best head to have. And this is a 325 IS, so it would make sense. Oh, I also need to show you guys the head in general. We got the shafts back in. After I machined the end of it, it slid back in, no problem. We have the Ireland Racing Performance heavy duty rockers. So these have a much thicker ear back here. So these are not prone to break like the stock ones. And even when we were removing this, when we were removing the old rocker arms, one of the rocker arms broke. So like they were on their way out. We didn't clean the exhaust side. I'll clean the exhaust side tomorrow. It just has a little bit of gasket left on it, but it's not as dirty. The intake side, bro, took forever. I ended up just getting my die grinder and grinding it down carefully. I think it should still seal. There's no crazy grooves in it and stuff, but I really hope it doesn't leak. But anyways, here's the casting I was telling you guys about. Right here, you can see it ends in 885, so that's like an 885 head, I believe. But it also has the BMW logo, and I don't know if they also have the BMW logo or if their AMC is a separate company. But yeah, these are the castings on this side. Here's how it looks like from the top, if it helps anyone. And then over here above cylinder two on the exhaust side, it has a 2.5 casting for the 885 that I searched up online. I'm gonna do some more research, but I think it's an 885 head, and if it is, I'm hyped, but someone in the comments break my heart if it isn't. But yeah, that's good news at least. Hopefully tomorrow we can get everything put back together, and then maybe Friday I'll come and just put all the fluids in it. I gotta top off the transmission fluid and just do small stuff to the car to get it running. But hopefully tomorrow, who knows, maybe tomorrow we'll bang everything out, put everything back in, and get the car started. But I'm super hyped to get this car driving. The head's back together, all that's left is just put everything back together, so hopefully everything goes smoothly. Next clip will be tomorrow, and we'll be reassembling the car. Day three? Yeah. Day three. I threw the fucking eccentric by accident. Imagine we lost this shit, I just bought. Damn. Got the homie David here again. He already put on the head, so that's gonna be a fucking big ass head start.
He got the head in already. We got all the bolts. Basically, they're all hand threaded. Yeah. Did you build a block out, the threads out with the compressor?
Oh, no.
We should probably take them out because there's probably oil in the threads. He got the exhaust manifolds on, the intake manifolds on. The thermostat housing is over there. That's just pretty wet, no? Yeah, we got basically everything. Right now, we're going to take out the bolts and we're going to blow compressed air into the actual block thread so we don't break anything when we torque them.
And then I got an oil pan gasket right here. And then I went over to Ireland Engineering and I picked up the missing nut that we have. And we're gonna try and pull the oil pan today too. It should be pretty easy. Take off the motor mounts, raise the motor like a couple inches, and then the oil pan should just drop out. Because like I said, we lost this bolt. I don't wanna risk it being in my oil pan and jumping up and down, falling into my crankshaft, falling into like the timing or something. I just don't wanna risk it. So that's gonna have to be done before the car's driving. I got oil for it. Got some thick ass VR1 Valvoline oil, 20W50. Because I showed you guys the piston rings have a lot of, not a lot, but they have a little bit of play. So I think a thicker oil is going to be needed on a 40-year-old engine. It makes sense. And then after this, we just put everything back together, radiator, all that. Take off the oil pan, put fluids in it, and should be ready for its first start. I have never heard this car start besides with a bad rocker. So I'm excited to see. Hopefully everything goes smoothly.
Go. Move it.
we got the head torqued down. It's not going nowhere. Everything's in place. All the rockers are in place. I'm pretty sure the head is in timing still. It might be like a millimeter off, but we'll fix that in a bit.
Right now, we're gonna go ahead and get this cam gear back on. Hopefully, it goes on smoothly. We're gonna put this cam gear back on so that once this cam gear is on, we just have to put the intake manifold, the thermostat housing, and the exhaust headers. And then while David's doing that, or while I'm doing that, one or the other, we're gonna jack up the car, and one of us is gonna be replacing the oil pan underneath, because like I said, we have to find that bolt that was dropped earlier, and we just wanna make sure it's not in the oil pan.
We're gonna jack off the car. We're gonna jack off the car 4 feet in the air.
It's all oil through that.
The head is in, it's torqued, and yeah, feeling good, feeling good. Let's get the rest of this car done. I am so over this car, bro. I never want to see another E30 in my life. Jokes aside, everything's finished. I'm like 90% done. David already left. He had something to do. Doing the valve lash on this car, it's easy, but one tip if you have an M20. David lost one of these, one of the hardware for one of the rockers. Basically like the screw, the washer, and the nut. I had the eccentric, but he lost the... David lost this nut. We still don't know where it is, but I bought a new one. Anyways, I assembled the head. I left this eccentric out because I don't have the bolt. Never try to put the eccentric.
Never try to swap your eccentrics while the head's in the car.
If you don't know about adjusting valve lash and stuff, you're not gonna have any idea what I'm saying. But if you know about adjusting valve lashes with rockers and eccentric bolts, never change an eccentric or install a head without a rocker having an eccentric. I thought, I was like, oh, I'll just swap the eccentric in. Once the head's inside the car, it'll be easy. Hell nah. I shit you not, it took me almost an hour right now just to get that one eccentric in the rocker and get the bolt to go through. I could not get the bolt to go through for the life of me. That was harder than actually putting the head. I was so frustrated. That was the worst job I've had to do in a while. The car's put back together, the head's on, it's torqued. I already adjusted all the valves are adjusted. I marked them with paint, so everything in the top is ready. All I have to do is put the valve cover back on. David already helped me put the radiator. The whole throttle body is on, the whole air intake is on, the radiator's on. I literally just have to put the valve cover back on, the spark plug wires, and that's everything in the top. I have to fill it up with oil, I have to bleed the coolant, and I'm also gonna top off the transmission fluid. So it's already 6:30. I go into work tonight at 10. I'm probably not gonna sleep today, but I really wanna get this car done. Hopefully I can take it to work and test drive it.
Yeah, man, that was crazy. That was literally crazy.
Let me get the rest of this stuff on. I'm probably not gonna record it because I'm dead tired. Hopefully tomorrow you guys see this car and it's on the street, because man, I'm so over it. I was gonna change the trans fluid, but I can't because I don't have the right socket, and I don't even know what fluid I need for it. So I think I'm gonna hit up my homie and find out what fluid I need.
Bro, I'm out of breath. I've been rushing.
Everything in the front is ready. I already put oil in the motor. It might need a little bit more, but literally all that's left is to put coolant in it. So I'm gonna try and bleed the car while it's still on jack stands, just in case something leaks underneath. I could take a look underneath, but hopefully nothing leaks, and hopefully just needs the coolant bled.
I don't even know how to bleed the coolant.
I'm just gonna wing it, but I'm gonna turn on right now so you guys are gonna hear it. I'm gonna hear it for the first time. I've never heard this car turn on without a broken rocker, so I'm so excited, but I'm also nervous. We basically had this whole motor apart, so I'm really hoping everything goes well. Let me connect the battery and get it turned on.
This is the first start in like a month or two. And this is the first time I'm gonna hear the car, bro. I'm so excited, but I'm also so nervous, but everything should be tight. We already checked everything. Pray for me in the comments. I'm a fucking idiot. Dude, I still had this fucking 22 millimeter on the main crank bolt. I really hope that didn't fuck shit up. Fuck, that was scary. I mean, it sounds good. I mean, I'm gonna let the car idle for like 20 minutes basically, just make sure everything's good before I even drive it. I turned the car on after I took off the wrench that was on the crank bolt. I was turning the crankshaft the way that the car moves, and I think that weird noise when I started it up was it was spinning the socket really fast. The scary part is the car started making a weird, like, it's almost like a belt squeak or like a scraping noise, and the exhaust manifolds are smoking like crazy. So I don't know if it's the exhaust gaskets just burning off the excess stuff from like barely being installed,
but it's a lot of smoke. Hopefully that clears up. If not, right now I'm gonna try to tighten the exhaust manifolds a little bit more, see if that's the problem. I don't think I'm gonna drive the car out of here because of that weird noise. It sounds like a scraping noise. It's honestly pretty scary. Hopefully it's nothing major. At first it kind of sounded like something was on the belt. Imagine it's that fucking little bolt that David dropped in the oil pan, and that's the reason why it's making that weird noise.
Let's see if it makes that noise again.
You hear that noise? I have no idea what it is. Hopefully it's something. It's calming down a little bit. I don't know. Let me keep an eye on it. See if it gets any worse. Pray for me. I'm so happy right now, bro. I don't know if you guys can tell. The squeaking went away. Oh my god. Bro, this is gonna sound cheesy, but one of the main reasons I got into cars was because of Chris Fix. I'm sure a lot of you guys maybe not got into cars. I like cars before Chris Fix, but Chris Fix is a big reason why I work on my own cars. And I was like, dude, like, I was just scared because I left the wrench on the crank hub and I was like, fuck, like, hopefully nothing's fucked up in the bottom end of the car. And then out of nowhere, it just started squeaking. And I was like, fuck, but it sounded like a scraping too. I was like, dude, it's probably the belt. Like, it's probably the fucking belt, but who knows? It sounded weird. I've never heard a squeak like that. You guys heard it on the camera. It didn't sound like a normal belt squeak. Years ago, I've watched a Chris Fix video that he shows how to put WD-40 onto a belt if it's squeaking, to find out where the squeak is coming from. I don't have WD-40, but I got some PB Blaster. And I put a little bit of PB Blaster onto the back of the main belt, and it stopped squeaking. The second the oil touched it, it stopped squeaking. So it's probably from all the cooling, all the oil when we were working on the car, it probably got onto the actual belts. But dude, I'm so fucking happy. I'm debating right now if I should take it for a test drive. I have no one with me, but I'm gonna go home, drop off the daily, and see if my dad can come drop me off, and that way he could drive with me back and be behind me just in case something happens to the E30. But the squeak is gone.
There's a slight ticking coming from the head. The smoking also stopped from the exhaust manifold, so I'm pretty sure that was just from the gaskets because I tightened the fuck up the bolts, so I was pretty sure it wasn't the bolts. There's a little bit of ticking in the head, but it's not too bad. Let me check the coolant level.
The temperature gauge inside of here doesn't work. The last owner just texted me, told me to smack it a couple times. Oh, I just cracked my dash. I don't know, he told me to smack the dash a couple times, so maybe when I'm actually driving it'll fix itself. But right now it's saying I have no gas and the temperature's low, and for sure the temperature's not low, so I really gotta figure that out or put an aftermarket gauge in there or something.
That's gonna be the next thing, because I'm not, especially after driving a head gasket and draining all the coolant, I wanna make sure I'm not overheating. So hopefully I really gotta fix that before I start driving it. Other than that, man, everything's ready. Let me check the coolant level.
It's almost where it needs to be. A little bit low, it's a little bit high, but anything that's over, if it's overflowing, it'll push it all out through here to the ground.
And everything underneath the car, nothing's leaking.
What is this? I think it's the PB Blast I just sprayed. Oh, that's a little bit of coolant. Damn, where's that coming from?
There's a small puddle of coolant. Hopefully it doesn't get any bigger. But I'm gonna let the car idle for a bit. I'm just so happy that the squeaking was actually the belt, dude.
I'm so happy. I really thought it was something bad. Right now the car sounds great. There's a slight ticking. I might need to do another valve adjustment later. I just kind of did it quick, but I think I did it fine. But I was kind of rushing.
I'm trying to get the coolant gauge to work. I don't think it's gonna work.
Damn, I think this car needs a new clutch. The clutch doesn't bite too hard. I mean, you could hear the ticking, but BMWs tick a lot. Let me get home and see if my dad could come help me. I think I'm gonna drive it. Yo.
Yo, how's the phone?
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
I'm in that bitch right now.
The car good?
I don't know, bro. It's scary. The temperature doesn't work. It's idling fine though.
How does it sound?
Hold up, I'll let you hear it right now. I gotta show you guys, the coolant temp worked. I smacked the shit out the thing right here, like the pass owner said, and it actually worked, dude. I'm fucking dead. I got David on the phone right now too. David, say what's up to him.
Hey, what's up, gang?
Oh shit, is that overheating, bro?
Damn,
bro, I'm gonna take this shit to work, bro. Hey, I The first thing I did was I went in after idle for a bit. I turned on the fucking the sound system. I was bumping Playboi Carti in this motherfucker. I forgot exactly what the last clip was. I think we had just gotten, I just got the car running and I took it out the garage. The car seems to be fine. Right after the last clip, I took it to work. It drove to work fine and I drove it an hour and a half to my girlfriend's house. Now I just have to decide what I want to do with this car. So let me know what you guys want to see. I kind of want to keep it like original. I don't want to do anything crazy to this car. I want to kind of just basically restore it. I do want to engine swap it in the future because this M20 in here is just too slow for this car. So it would be cool to either boost it or swap it, but I think I'm just going to swap it. But for the most part, this car is intact. It's super clean. I'm super hyped to have it. Let me know if you guys are excited as I am to see this car on the channel because, dude, I'm so hyped. The car's all there. Everything with the car is working fine. And I'm just super excited to have it, man. But let me give you guys a few details of the car and then we'll cut into why I bought it and everything. All right, so like I said, this is my new 1987 BMW 325iS. It has the M20 motor. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I don't know everything about E30s. I just know that 325iS is basically the best E30 to buy, besides the M3, of course. Overall, the car is just in pretty good condition. I'd give it, in general, like a 1 through 10. I'd give it like a 7 on the outside. It has a bunch of like small dings and stuff, so it's not perfect at all. It's a good like 15 footer. From 15 feet away, it looks immaculate. But obviously, it's like a 40-year-old car. Has a bunch of imperfections. It's on E36 M3 wheels with the floater center cap, so I'm super hyped about that. The original color of this car was like a metallic, like brown, kind of bronze color, but it was repainted, but they did a great job. It looks like they took out all the seams and stuff. Like, there's no overspray on the windows or any of the trim. A lot of the trim was replaced when it was painted, so that's great. And yeah, just overall, the car's in really great shape. Like, I wish you guys could feel the paint. It feels like my old 335i. It feels super clean. For the outside, that's basically what it is. Not much else left to it besides the wheels, and it's on adjustable springs, so that's why it's a little bit lower than stock. One of the main reasons why I bought this car was because of the interior, dude. The interior is immaculate. So the door cards are nice and intact. It has the sport seats in here, which are like four-way adjustable. So this comes out a little bit. I think the headrest tilts. This tilts, and I think the whole seat moves like up and down and front and back. So, and these seats have been reupholstered because I don't think this is the original. I don't think any 325i came with like this Alcantara like suede kind of texture. It feels like a suede leather almost. So this is honestly my favorite part of the car, the interior, the seats and the back seats. So basically, like, the seats are immaculate. They're in perfect condition. It has a renowned steering wheel, or renowned, I don't know how you say that, but it has a suede or Alcantara steering wheel. It has an aftermarket double din, which I'm going to be replacing this because I don't think it matches the actual vibe of the car, but this is sick to have. I'm going to be fixing the AC soon. It doesn't have AC. Of course, it has the Get Rag 260. One of the first things we're going to be doing on this car to fix it is we definitely have to fix this plate. This is in first gear right now. It has a manual transmission that I wanted, so. Some of the gauges don't work. I gotta fix that. Obviously, it has the E30 typical crack dash, like 240s as well. I'm going to be trying to find a stock dash. If anyone watching this has an E30 part out and has a crackless dash, hit me up. I'm going to be putting a carpet overlay for now, but if anyone watching this, I'm sure someone with E30s has watching this and they have a spare crackless dash laying around, hit me up, DM me on Instagram. Sunroof doesn't work, I gotta fix that. The headliner's like in basically brand new condition. Like, the interior is just beautiful. Overall, with the outside being like a 7, and I give the interior honestly like a 9 or 8 because obviously it's not perfect, but just overall, dude, this car in general is like an 8 or 9. Like, I love this car and I'm so hyped to have it. The last owner thought the motor was blown. And the way he was describing it to me, I was like, dude, I don't think the motor's blown. It sounded like he really didn't know much about cars. He wasn't too mechanically inclined and he was really young. I think the last owner of this car was like 19. It's crazy, dude. He had this car for like 3 years. He got it when he was like 16 or something like that. So he dated this car for a while. I went to go look at the car, turned it on, everything checked out. Even if the motor was blown, I was still gonna buy it because obviously it's way easier to come up on an M20 or even an M50 swap than an E30 in this condition, so. I ended up turning it on. It sounded like it was coming from the head, and like you guys saw in this video, it was just a broken rocker arm, and that's all it was. I should go buy a lottery ticket because my luck with cars has been immaculate recently. The truck and then this car now, like, I'm super hyped about it. That's gonna be it for today's video. I hope you guys are excited as I am to have this car on the channel. I don't even know what we're gonna be doing until next, but I'm sure this car needs a lot of more work and I'll figure something out. But I'll see you guys next time. Thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed any moment in this video, please consider subscribing. Drop a like, really helps out a lot, especially for a small channel like mine. Next video should be the 240 of the track because I have my truck ready. I have the 240 ready. And yeah, I wasn't expecting to get a new car, but got a lot of new stuff planned. Hopefully everything works out, but I got a lot of work ahead of me. I'll see you guys next time. Thank you guys for watching. Later.